The Boomers' generation was the richest generation in the history of the United States. After World War II, the entire world was recovering from the deadliest war in history, but the war didn't take place in the US soil, so the United States took the best advantage out of it and boosted its exports, helping the rest of the world to recover and made a fortune in the process. That's one of the main reasons how the US dollar replaced the British pound as the world currency reserve. However, as time went by, boomers passed their wealth to Generation X, who also enjoyed a pretty high standard of living. Home ownership was almost 70%, but that prosperity didn't last long, because when it came to millennials, things went south. Despite their higher earnings, millennials still hold less wealth than previous generations did at their age. When boomers were roughly the same age as millennials are now, they owned about 21% of America's wealth, compared to millennials' 5% share today, according to recent Fed data. What do you think is the average millennials' millionaire's net worth? There are 600,000 18 millennial millionaires in the US, and 93 of them have a net worth ranging from $1 to $2.5 million. Most of them probably live in states like California or New York, where $1 or $2 million net worth doesn't really mean much, since home prices, for example, in California are around $1 million. If you're one of them, then good for you, but if you're not, then don't worry, because we all attain wealth at a different age. It is not like a step-by-step process that we all have to follow simultaneously as we did back in school, moving from one grade to another. That school mentality doesn't work here. Some people make it when they are still teenagers, others when they are in their 50s or 60s. It's just a game that prolongs throughout your entire life. But the question is, how do you know that you are on the right path? How do you know that you will become financially free in the future? The truth is that wealth is unpredictable. Success in general is unpredictable. Have you ever heard the statistics that 9 out of 10 startups fail, for example? So even if you try launching your own business, you're not guaranteed to succeed. In fact, you'll most probably fail. However, what you can do is raise your chances of success by taking the right daily decisions that will accumulate over time. Just compare someone who saves, let's say, 20% of his income and someone else who doesn't save anything. Let's assume everything stays the same. Over the course of a few years, one will have the capital to invest or take a break to start a business, while the other will have to keep his job because he won't be able to pay the bills. So here are the 5 signs that you will make a lot of money in the future. If you're ready, give this video a thumbs up and let's start with the first one. You know how to tell stories. If you take a look at the most successful companies in the world, they all have one thing in common. They know how to tell stories. You can build the most amazing product or service in the world, but if you do not know how to market it, then there is no use in it because people won't give it a shot. Steve Jobs was the master of storytelling. If you have watched his first iPhone presentation, you could clearly see that. Steve begins the presentation by masterfully building suspense. A touchscreen iPod, an iPhone, an internet communicator, what is he up to? Then even as the audience is starting to catch on, he lingers in suspense a bit longer before making the reveal. A 3-in-1 mobile phone that would change the world forever. The same applies to YouTube. Most successful creators are the ones who know how to tell great stories. People enjoy when the facts are presented in an interesting story. That's why we watch Netflix, go to movies, or watch vloggers like Casey Neistat, who, by the way, stopped uploading videos for a while now. Number 2. You're always curious. If you take a look at the history, you will find out that what makes people really rich is the fact that they solved a simple problem. What led them to think about these problems is their curiosity. When the internet first started, it was all over the place. The only way you could find something is by knowing the name of that website. If you didn't know about Amazon, you would never be able to find it unless you heard about it in the news or someone would tell you. So these two guys, Sergey Brin and Larry Page, who were Stanford students back then, asked themselves a simple question. Why not make it easy to find things online? That's how they invented Google. It wasn't a complicated question, but their curiosity led them to ask the right questions, which led them to build a $2 trillion company. Take the example of Snapchat. Back then, when Facebook was cool, if you would post something on Facebook, it would stay there forever, unless you delete it. But if you delete it, people would think that you're hiding something. Something must be wrong with that post that you deleted, that picture or video or a statement. So Evan Spiegel decided to create a platform where you don't have to explain to people why you deleted that picture, because it is going to be deleted automatically. He called it Snapchat. That's where the stories came from. And then Facebook simply copied stories all across its platforms, like it always does. Number 3. You admire other successful people. It is easy to feel resentful when you are barely paying the bills while someone else is driving a Lambo or flying private. It is easy to point fingers at ultra wealthy people and mock them for spending so much money on things that are not important. But if you're going to be honest with ourselves, the vast majority of people would do the same thing if they were in their position. It is true that most wealthy people, if not all, have done some shady things, to say the least, to be where they are now. But that's the brutal truth of life. Business is war, and war has no rules. You're either going to crush others, or you will be crushed. You're left with no other option. But if you constantly look down at these people, thinking that you are morally better person than them because you are morally better human being, then that mindset will always keep you where you are. I'm not telling you to cheat people, but you should not look down at strong people who can make tough decisions. Sometimes when I go through YouTube comments, people just mock Bezos, for example, for divorcing his wife and dating Lauren Sanchez. Here's the thing, he's got one life. Let him enjoy what's left of it. He has changed our lives for the better. Just imagine for a moment how life would be without Amazon. Number 4. You understand accounting. When I graduated from high school, I had no idea what to do with my life, like many of you. So I decided to major in accounting and finance, because the only thing that interested me back then was the stock market. I can confidently tell you that understanding accounting is one of the key principles to succeed in business. Understanding accounting means understanding capitalism. You'll learn how business works from a financial perspective. If you haven't majored in accounting, don't worry. There are some great courses online that can teach you everything you need to know in a few months. You don't have to go back to school to learn all of that. We should be grateful that we're living in such an age. Number 5. You have mastered your emotions. Emotions play the most important part in our lives. Most of what we do is driven by our emotions. We become friends because we feel comfortable being around these people. We fall in love because he or she makes us feel special. When we look back at our lives, we remember the moments where we felt great. The problem is that when these emotions lead us to make horrible financial decisions, when your emotions lead you to impulsive spendings, when you feel bad because your friend got a better car, so you end up buying a car that you can't afford on credit just to impress your friends. Especially if you're starting a business. Business is like a roller coaster and it's an adventure. Every single day, things can go down in an instant, even though you have planned absolutely everything perfectly. You never know what is going to go wrong, and you can't just be mad at it, because that is not going to help you. You can't simply complain about it. You have to be able to accept the reality how it is. You have to learn how to accept chaos and not react to it emotionally and solve the problem right there at the moment. The same goes for investing. When you buy stocks, they just go up and down every single moment. Sometimes a crisis hits and everything goes down. You need to have the patience and self-control to not sell all of your stocks while this chaos goes away. The same applies when you're dealing with people. People come from different backgrounds with different sets of skills and mindsets. It is easy to get angry at people. It is easy to hate people for who they are because they're just different. That's why it's important to control your emotions if you want to build valuable connections to be able to build meaningful things. A good place to start making money is the stock market. But if you're new to the stock market, then I have created a short, fully animated course that will teach you everything you need to know about the stock market. The best part of it is that if you use the link in the description, you can get 2 weeks of Skillshare Premium, which means you can get the course for free. On top of that, you can get 2 free stocks from Webull if you use the link in the description. If you have enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you're new around here, then subscribe and turn on your notifications. Thanks for watching, and until next time.